End of Chapter 7. Chapter 8. General Ginger's Army. Tip was so anxious to rejoin his man Jack and the Sawhorse that he walked a full half the distance to the Emerald City without stopping to rest. Then he discovered that he was hungry, and the crackers and cheese he had provided for the journey had all been eaten. While wondering what he should do in this emergency, he came upon a girl sitting by the roadside. She wore a costume that struck the boy as being remarkably brilliant, her silken waist being of emerald green and her skirt of four distinct colors, blue in front, yellow at the left side, red at the back, and purple at the right side. Fastening the waist in front were four buttons, the top one blue, the next yellow, the third red, and the last purple. The splendor of this dress was almost barbaric, so Tip was fully justified in staring at the gown for some moments before his eyes were attracted by the pretty face above it. Yes, the face was pretty enough, he decided, but it wore an expression of discontent coupled to a shade of defiance or audacity. While the boy stared, the girl looked upon him calmly. A lunch basket stood beside her, and she held a dainty sandwich in one hand and a hard-boiled egg in the other, eating with an evident appetite that aroused Tip's sympathy. He was just about to ask a share of the luncheon when the girl stood up and brushed the crumbs from her lap. "There," said she, "it is time for me to go. Carry the basket for me and help yourself to its contents if you are hungry." Tip seized the basket eagerly and began to eat, following for a time the strange girl without bothering to ask questions. She walked along before him with swift strides, and there was about her an air of decision and importance that led him to suspect she was some great personage. Finally, when he had satisfied his hunger, he ran up beside her and tried to keep pace with her swift footsteps, a very difficult feat, for she was much taller than he and evidently in a hurry.